very good afternoon, ma'am. Abhishek this side, welcome you on our platform, College Duniya Thoughts on Education, and where this is a thoughtful leader campaign. So the very first question which I want to ask you is, being a faculty of the Dr. SPM University, what are your roles and responsibilities towards the students?
Being a faculty member, I'm also a research scholar. So I am in that juncture of my point when I'm a student, simultaneously I'm a teacher. So I have the psychology of both the people, students and teacher both. And I am really enjoying this phase because when you are giving lecture, you stand behind the podium and you have a different worldview. The whole classroom is open to you and students look up to you with expectation. They watch, they know you are standing there, so you will give them knowledge. And that respect, that reverence, you can see in their eyes. And there your responsibility become doubles. Whatever you are teaching, it should be up to the mark. It should be relevant. It should be contemporary. So my focus in my class remains to that, to update them with the current knowledge, to teach them properly. So basically, I'm stick to that while continuing my study also. But whatever I feel that I missed in my college day, I try to fill that gaps with them. Like most of the time, we were very hesitant to talk to our professors. Like what if they'll scold us? What if they'll not agree with us or something like that? So I always make sure that I have a very cordial relationship with them where they're not hesitant to ask anything. That is my first priority in the class. Until and every student must have doubts in their mind. If you have doubt, that means you're studying. And if you don't have doubts, that means
you're not paying attention.
So I constantly, this is my motto, that to break them out of their shells and ask questions, no matter what. Maybe it will sound stupid to some people, but you ask. You come up with questions and I'm there to answer. How stupid it is, I don't know, but you ask. And this will also leave their stage fear and talking, public speaking and everything. So this is my first motto, to go there, have a cordial relationship with my student and take them out of their shell. This is the thing.
Nice experience, ma'am. So how do you tend to establish a healthy relation with the students and fellow faculty?
The first thing is, sir, I personally believe that you should be very calm and composed while taking class. The more you are aggressive, the student will think, you're the bahut khadus hai. They will not approach you for anything. So the first thing that I try to, I have a very calm and composed atmosphere. Like even if there are disturbing elements in the class, I try to shut off with some humorous thing. Not paying attention to them, what you are doing or something like that. So my to maintain a healthy relationship with them, what I do is I try to have a friendly kind of relationship with where when they are walking by, I'll ask how are you, something simple, so that they don't fear welcoming to me. So to maintain a healthy relationship with them, my first priority is to have a cordial, very cordial, calm and composed relationship with them. And then after, if time, because we are teacher, most of the time we lose control at certain things. But then also I try, if I'm scolding someone, the next step is I'll go to that person and explain why I scolded you and why he should apologize for his behavior, his or her behavior. So at that way, they feel comfortable with you. And when they see that teachers is getting angry and the person has not been so angry for long, he or she is getting angry, so they also feel, ye to kabhi gussa nahi karti thi, aaj why she is aise. So they also feel bad in themselves, ki maine zarur kuch zyada galat kar diya. So that is for most primary thing that a teacher should do in class. Have that cordial, calm, composed, composing in class. Then only your student will listen to you.
Yes, that's a big point. So how do you try to bring in practical approach towards student, towards subjects and make it industry oriented?
See, as you have seen that in literature also, we are moving ahead with time. So many subjects there that needs daily updating, like current theories, there are some like feminist theory here, which there are many theories that are going on. So what I do is when I go to class, I ask them, okay, what is your understanding? Because literature is open to interpretation. No matter what you say, everyone, if you justify your point, you are good. So this is the first thing when I go with a topic in my mind, where I am teaching a topic, when I go there, so there are some theories related. So again, so I go and I give them the topic. You do, and jo tumhare man mein, what you are feeling about this topic, you just tell me. Right or wrong, that is up to me. I'll judge you. I'm the judge. But you speak. So this is the thing that I always do. I pick up the topics that are very relevant, up to date, because they need to understand. In NET also, they are asking the same question, the current theories and criticism and everything. So because I myself have been giving those exams, so I pick out the topics that are very much relevant in the competitive exams. So with their course, I try to include that thing. The UGC NET preparation, so I try to merge those things. जो टॉपिक पढ़ा रहे हैं उस टॉपिक से आपके यूजीसी से जो इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है उसको उसमें मिला देते हैं एंड देन वी हैव अ ब्रॉडर अंडरस्टैंडिंग व्हाट वी हैव टू रीड इन डेक्स सो दैट वी कैन क्वालिफाई द नेट इन फर्स्ट को
अलोंग विद द डिग्री दे आर आल्सो गेटिंग प्रिपेयर फॉर द कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स आल्सो
यस यस
दैट्स वेरी नाइस मैम सो हाउ डू यू हेल्प योर स्टूडेंट्स टू कॉप अप विद द कॉम्पिटिशन बीइंग सो हाई इन द आउटसाइड
First thing I always go in the class and I say ki it's perfectly okay if you don't qualify net in the first go. Don't take it to your heart. Like this is world, this is life and eventually you will end up somewhere. But agar beech mein rasta thak ke haar jaoge to you will go nowhere. So if you are appearing for competitive exam, keep this in mind that rejection will welcome you first and then this garland of success will come to your neck. So the first thing that I always said ये दिमाग में सोच के नहीं करना है कि नहीं होगा तो फिर कुछ नहीं होगा नहीं होगा तो वी विल वर्क हार्डर वी विल वर्क मोर हार्डर बट एंड ऑल्सो आई टेल देम दैट नेट इज नॉट अबाउट हाउ मच यू नो इट्स अबाउट हाउ यू शुड नो लाइक व्हाट यू शुड रीड सो एंड इट्स परफेक्टली ओके इफ यू आर नॉट क्वालिफाइंग इन द फर्स्ट गो इट्स वेरी मच ऑब्वियस लाइक होता है बट इट डजंट मीन दैट यू शुड नॉट वर्क हार्ड यू शुड वर्क हार्ड एंड टेक आउट टाइम टाइम मैनेजमेंट इज वन ऑफ द ग्रेट थिंग दैट our faculty member ensure to everybody like if we try to finish our classes before 12 so that after 12 they have enormous amount of time with them and they can study for their any competitive exam not for NET JRF but for any SSC banking or anything that they want so time management is one of the most important thing that they should learn at this step only because after this when they leave this college the world is huge and competition is so high neck cutting competition is there so From this day only, if you are managing your time, like I am giving time to my college, I am giving time to my assignment, I am giving time to whatever notes my teacher is providing, and then I am getting my time for other competitive exam. Then only they can succeed. And if you are thinking मेरे पास अभी बहुत time है, once I will finish my course, then I will go to that, then that will be too late. So the preparation starts from day one. You are taking admission in PG classes, your preparation starts from this day only. Don't wait for tomorrow. कि कल से start करेंगे. This कल is a very danger zone when you keep things for kal yes then it's so this I always talk to them with my students in the class you don't wait for kal do what you want to do today only start from today don't postpone things
okay ma'am so what are the challenges you faced to uplift the quality of education of your department
See, when I joined here, I was not the one who started from scratch. This department was already very well today. Ma'am was there, sir was there, and classes were going on. So there are some government college where you know classes are not going properly or something. Students are not coming. So those problem I didn't face. Luckily, I was one of those member who joined the college when students were coming on time. Even after this COVID period, we were the first college who started the offline classes. So for me, it was very cordial. Students were coming on time. Discipline was maintained. They were coming in dress code. For uplifting, yes, because you see, this college has a mixture of students who come from Jack Board also, CBSE also, ICSE also. So many a time, what happens is, although we are from English faculty, but we have to switch to Hindi language.
Yes.
Because
of the reason.
Yeah. They are coming from different boards. They are coming. Some are from Bihar. Some are from Jharkhand. Some are from Delhi. So to have a kind of equity in the class, to maintain that equity. So many a time we have to jump to Hindi. We feel bad like being a department of English, we should only be thorough in English, we should teach in English. But many a time we have to jump to that level like, to push them forward. Because else, if we will bombard them with English language, they won't understand. And if even one person is not understanding what I am teaching, then me as a teacher is a failure. That's what I personally feel. So that's why I always ensure to switch language in between because I have seen that most of the students in our college are from Jagpur. And there they don't pay that much importance to English language speaking and writing. So we always ensure, HOD sir always conducts some classes where he talks about writing skill, how you should improve writing skills. He's also running his YouTube channel where he's teaching how you should read, what you should read. So all the extra things along with your course syllabus, we are taking care need of that. And we genuinely wish ki the student who is sitting in the last corner bench, he also uplifts. This is our motto, personally. So we are very much into that, and especially we focus on writing skills and reading skills. Then we correct the examination, the copies for mid-semester and all that. So we call the student personally in the department and say that, see, this is how you write. This should not be written. This is the other way around. Beech-beech mein we ask them to write applications and something, because if we are the literature person. Hum logon ka communicative English utna nahi hota hai. So this is on this, our part, it become very mandatory that we teach them how to write, how to speak, how to interact with your seniors, what you should. So we have made a proper WhatsApp group, and there also we try ki people are getting daily dose of thoughts, quotes, and we are teaching the basic knowledge that if a professor is texting you, what you should reply. Because when they finish their college, they will go to some institution where they will have to face a PI, where they will have to face a senior. So how you should talk, in what tone you should talk, what should your posture be. These all things we take care of them if we get time. These may thoda thoda. It's like that.
Yes, ma'am. So you are personality development type ki classes you can consider for that.
This is part of our life. We feel that the students need that. It's not always, but sometimes yes, when we feel that they are lacking somewhere, we try to ensure that gap is filled.
So moving to the next question, ma'am. So when you come to the college, what was your vision and how are you trying to achieve that same?
My vision when I came to college was to deliver a lecture that sweeps in their head. That was my first priority. When I enter the class, I personally feel that whatever a teacher is telling in Hindi, in English, in French, in Greek, in whatever language I am teaching, it should sweep in their head so that they can produce that same thing in their own words in the paper. So first thing is understanding, to make them understand the topic very well. Once they have understood the topic, then they can produce anything. And being a literature student, we are very much good at making stories. But the thing is, one should have a hold over the content. So, and like people say, like in maths, first you have to understand what are the basics, x, y, z, 1, 2, 3 numbers and something like that. So in English also, we have some very basics, like we have division of ages and then. So we try ki pehle aapka base puri achhe se clear ho jaye. Base is the first more thing. So while teaching and while explaining, I always focus on the base. Once your base is concrete, your divisions are clear, your everything is clear, then you can produce answer. Then it's up to you, can write answer, write question and anything like that. But first thing is like that. That is a priority, to make them understand the basic concept. And that was my vision. I always wanted to be that sweet kind of teacher who who ensure that people are getting what I'm teaching.
So that's very nice, ma'am. So what do you see the department's greatest strength and how it can be enhanced?
Greatest strength, as ma'am said, I totally agree with her, that a strong faculty member will produce strong semesters. This I firmly believe in, because teachers are the people who are held responsible for shaping the future of children. And when we are coordinated, when we respect each other, we see the same things in the eyes of them. So this is the first thing that I think this is the strength of our department. And second thing is, we are very interactive. There is no barrier between students and teacher, like we are senior, you are junior, you should maintain discipline. Discipline is there, but in a form that they are very cordial with us. And this, every faculty member, we ensure that they come to us. Once they will start fearing us, they will not come up with their doubts. So first thing that everybody here ensures, that we have such persona and personality in ourselves that they don't fear us. Unko respect hai wo sab cheez hai, but they should not fear us coming with their doubts and questions.
Communication gap
yahan pe bilkul nahi hai. This is one of the best thing that I think is great about this department. And second, as sir was discussing yesterday, we are trying to have the concept of human library, where eminent people from their fields will come and talk to our students, and they share their life experience with them and batayenge ki what all happened in there when they were young and what is missing in this generation. So because COVID ke chalte sari libraries band hai, so we need to have that kind of conversation where students come to know about certain things of life. पढ़ाई लिखाई सब अपनी जगह है, बट अल्टीमेट गोल इज टू प्रोड्यूस गुड ह्यूमन बीइंग्स, एज मैम सेड. सो टू मेक देम गुड ह्यूमन बीइंग्स, वी नीड टू हैव दैट टाइप ऑफ एटमॉस्फेयर जहां पे लोग एक दूसरे का इज्जत करे, सम्मान करे, एंड नॉट बिकॉज आई एम फोर्सिंग यू टू डू सो, बट इट शुड कम आउट ऑफ जनरली नेचुरली. दिस
सो मूविंग टू द लास्ट क्वेश्चन मैम, सो व्हाट वैल्यूएबल एडवाइस वुड यू लाइक टू गिव स्टूडेंट्स फॉर देम टू हैव अ प्रॉस्पेरस करियर एट?
Advice I will give, never stop learning, no matter what. Try to make it a habit that you learn at least 5 new words daily. Yeah, try to use it in your daily life. Try to use it. Try to communicate with your friends. Spread those five words to some another friend. They will introduce you to five another words. So my motto in life is, once you will stop learning, you will be a passive asset to the society. Be an active member of the society where you are eager to learn. That hunger for knowledge is the thing that will keep you moving in your life. So that is the thing that you should never be a student. You are a student throughout your life. Because I have seen my faculty members when they come for class, they have their notes and everything ready before they go to class, and they revise it thoroughly before they enter the class. So that, I think, is the beauty of being in this profession, that you are constantly reading, you are constantly knowing something, you are gaining something. And that I communicate to my student, that no matter what happens, read a book daily, read newspaper, read anything, but gain something. Don't sit passively, kal dekhenge that thing, kal dekhenge nahi. Make it a habit of reading every day, learning something new. Be it life, zaruri nahi hai padhai likhai ka, life se related, emotions se related, behavior se related, psychology se. Movie dekh lo koi nahi, usko analyze karke apne blog pe dalo. Anything, learn, keep learning. This is the thing that one should always do.
Thank you very much, ma'am. It was a very nice talking to you.
Same here. Thank you so much.